welcome back, you guys, to our channel. It's your boy, Shawn.
And your girl, Mel.
Let's get it. Welcome back, S&M Squad. It's your boy, Shawn.
And your girl, Mel.
It's your favorite couple, y'all. We are back.
Back at it again, guys.
With the greatest of all time, which is Elvis the GOAT Presley.
Yes, yes, yes.
Reacting to
Elvis Presley and the black community.
You guys.
That echo will never die.
Yes, yes, yes.
Guys, you guys requested, this was very highly requested.
Definitely.
And I'm just, you know, sad that we didn't do it sooner, but better late than never, because this one is definitely relevant.
Definitely. This the one that connected, you know, all the pieces to the puzzle right here. For me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And probably for a lot of us, you know, because Elvis wanted to reach out to the black community, you know, and he was well known, you know, well known. So I just want to respect that.
You know, and he loved the black community.
Yeah, of course.
He was raised around the black community, you know. He wasn't born with a silver spoon in his mouth.
Right.
Like a lot of people who don't really know Elvis think that he was. No, Elvis knew about the ghetto because he was born, you know, in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
His family had it really hard coming up, and, you know, he's a success story. He's a success story.
Yeah.
And it's such a beautiful story.
Definitely a beautiful story. And, you know, Elvis wasn't ashamed, you know, to tell you, you know, who he was and where he was from. You know, when you heard it all through his music, you know. You heard it all through his music, you know, clear as day.
Yes.
And, well, I can't wait to get into it.
Can't wait.
It's our first time checking this out. So, before this video start, I just want to ask you guys to like, comment, subscribe to the channel. You know, show us some love. Turn on your post notification bell, you know, and just stick with us. Because we got a long journey, you guys. A long journey.
Yes, we do.
Yes, sir. So, yes, you ready to get into it?
Of course. Let's do it.
Let's get into it. Elvis Presley, the black community. Echo will never die.
I thought he was a very beautiful, and still is, a very beautiful person, and his memory shall probably forever live on.
Well, you ain't nothing but a rabbit, you ain't no friend of mine.
There is no room in this city for the vulgar performances of Elvis Presley.
It's shocking.
What?
I watched him gyrate his legs and swivel his hips. And our parent-teachers group feels he should not be on television.
We've set up a 20-man committee to do away with this vulgar, animalistic, nigger rock and roll bar. Our committee will check with the restaurant owners and the cafes to see what Presley Records is on their machines, and then ask them to do away with them.
You've learned anything from the criticism leveled at you?
No, I haven't.
You haven't, huh?
Because I don't feel like I'm doing anything wrong.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Rock and roll has got to go. And go it does at KWK. We're all through playing rock and roll records. This week is record-breaking week here at KWK. And after this week, no more rock and roll will be played on the air.
The obscenity and vulgarity of the rock and roll music is obviously a means by which the white man and his children can be driven to the level with a nigger. It is obviously nigger music.
Everybody mostly turned him down. And because first thing, he had Negroes ways. This is what they didn't really at that time, they didn't want to accept.
This could buy a black performance, and in essence, because of at that particular time, the kind of backwards mental capability that many people had, as judging a person because of the color of their skin is somewhat still does exist, but back then it was worse. And he actually, because of him being a Caucasian brother, he was able to do away with that whole thing.
The 77-year-old Early Wright, a disc jockey at radio station WROX in Clarksdale for 45 years.
Hi there. Pleasant good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How do you do? This is your soul man to be with you until I get three. I want you to stand by. Don't have no fear. Following Jay's show, should I play one like this one from out of here? Elvis Presley.
Elvis's songs still get good play on Wright's program among the blues, gospel, and jazz recordings that are its staples. It was almost 40 years ago when Elvis drove down to Clarksdale from Memphis with a record and asked him to play it.
And I had been playing his record, and I had never seen him before, and I was amazed to see him. When he introduced himself to being Elvis Presley, then I went all the pieces over. Then he and I started talking. I used to be the manager of a gospel group called the Four Star Quartet. And I could listen to a man sing a hymn. I could listen to a man sometime talk. I did that. And I could pick him out whether he could fit in my group. And talking to Elvis Presley, I could see a great future in him.
It's no accident that Wright recognized Elvis's strong gospel roots. Here at the East Trigg Baptist Church in Memphis, older members of the congregation remember Elvis joining in with the choir while in high school. These were rousing sessions led by the charismatic pastor, the Reverend W. Herbert Brewster.
Like most black people in the South, and to whose suit God has pressed down a harp of a thousand strings, it only needed tuning. Elvis's voice was that type of voice that agreed with the thought of Calvary. He had that kind of bent and inclination and attitude that suggested that God could use him.
I gave the music a different approach, a new beat. I knew that it wasn't going to hurt if I said, "Let's Jesus bear the cross alone," whether I've said with one beat, two beat, whether I've said it high or low. And I told them, "Come on in here and put your stuff together." They came in here, and it was a glorious experience, and Elvis was in that group.
Elvis came out with a style of his own, and it was very creative. And once he got into it and you got that feel, Elvis just took off like a late freight. And with Elvis doing this kind of music, gave an injection to black music that no other artist had ever done.
It was like an earthquake in my neighborhood. The whole place was shaking when he came on. And I said, how the person possessed that kind of power that it even comes off the TV and grabbed me in this ghetto neighborhood?
Elvis took my Tutti Frutti, and I was very disgusted. But by him singing it, he really made it bigger and made me bigger.
During those days, it was a white artist doing something, they would just say, they don't like our blacks and they don't like them either. He's nothing but a copycat. But Elvis Presley, when he came on, he was screaming and going crazy, and it was just like an animal neighborhood. And I said, this guy's got something going, man.
Elvis had something that made him sound like he truly meant it, and that's what made a lot of people like myself like him.
I think Elvis had lots of soul. He appealed to black people. You know, he definitely had to have soul in order to do that.
I think there's ever been an artist that when his name went on the marquee, they knew he was coming. People came from all over the world. I never heard of that.
Elvis did a lot of stuff that, you know, rappers do these days.
He had the bling. He gotta have the bling when he from Memphis.
He had the bling, you know, he had Cadillac, you know, he had like a gangster in him. As the snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto.
The song also resonates with people who've only met Elvis through his songs.
Elvis talking about the hood. You know, they're talking about where we come from.
Paul Beauregard and Jordan Houston are the Oscar-winning rap duo 3-6 Mafia. They grew up just two blocks from Graceland in one of Memphis's poorest neighborhoods.
I want to see you, Scratcher.
My mom used to always listen to a song when I was young. He talk about, you know, things that she went through. You know, she had like, you know, I'm gonna have a bunch of kids, like 9 kids. You know what I'm saying? That's how you gonna get somebody to listen to your song. You talk about what they know about, what they want to hear. And she know about the ghetto, because, you know, she live in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
That's it.
And his mama cries. But if there's one thing she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
After we find the part on the record that we want to use, we're sampling into the drum machine or the keyboard. That way we can loop it. Like
my first line says, first I'm broke, so I hang out with the rat and roach. It's still broke, so I'm sleeping on apartment floors. So it's just like the struggle, you know, what's going on in the hood. First I'm broke, so I hang out with the rat and roach. It's still broke, so I'm sleeping on apartment floors. And I was off beat, but it's all good, because it's on TV. Maybe do some edits. Make me look cool. Maybe put my name in the credits.
Once we have all that ready, you know, we load it into the drum machine and then...
Bam! So he starts to roam the streets at night, and he learns how to steal, and he learns how to fight. And they give him some marvelous everyday task. Watching your back for the man wearing the mask. I say you might get stuck if you in the hood looking like you came up. We ride old school whips, high off the ground, right beside a player hill. Cause I'm sleeping on the private floors. The drug is killer, kick when he smoke a grip. I never seen a drug dealer ever call it quits. The good struggle is to make it, gotta get the chain. See, every day is like a dark cloud full of rain. The feds tapping for his dangerous when you hood trapping. So don't get lost in the sauce, slinging cold crackling.
So help your brother along the way, no matter where he starts. The same God that made you made him too. These men with broken hearts.
Wow.
During the 60s and early 70s, when tensions between blacks and whites were at an all-time high, Elvis demonstrated his desire for racial reconciliation in the musicians that he chose and the treatment they received.
We first decided to take the gig with Elvis. We had no idea that there would be any racial flack regarding it. Our first racial encounter was when we went to Texas. Elvis was told by his people that, well, you can leave the black girls home. You don't have to bring them. Wow. So Elvis wasn't going to do the Astrodome unless his girls could be with him. And he demanded that we be given the star treatment. We had to be in our convertible where everybody could see us, and our little blonde could drive us. And that was his statement. You don't like it? Deal with it, or I'm not going to be there. And I thought that was very big of him.
When I joined the group in 1972, they took a big chance because there were no blacks in contemporary or Southern gospel music, and I was the first one, and it made all the headlines. Wow. and everything. It was in Billboard and all the newspapers in Tennessee. And my first time meeting Elvis was, he had a folder full of clippings of things that he had read about me. As a matter of fact, the Imperials brought me to his suite, and he gave me this folder with all the clippings, and he personally welcomed me into the family. And for a guy who, you know, didn't really know where he stood, this was very important that he acknowledged my presence and, you know, made me feel very much a part of what we were all doing. And right away, he treated me like he'd known me for years. He gave me one of those TCB chains and everything, and I was just one of the guys, and I never forgot that.
And I've been around him with people, other people of color, and I've only seen him give love. He was very generous to people that he didn't even know. You didn't have to be of any racial persuasion for him to love you.
And you know they have, you know how rumors get started when there's a big star or something, the people will start rumors, well, he doesn't like this kind of people or he doesn't like those people or that people. And I never got that from him.
But, you know, Elvis is a whole other thing. It's just, I think it's scary to even be compared to people in that, like, you know what I mean? Because he's such a big talent, and in his absence, he's, of course, he's bigger than in his presence. And music marks time, so in this time period, what Elvis was to his period would be something totally different. But I think rock and roll, I mean, is it, what he brought to Vegas is more than rock and roll. I mean, I think there's so much going on out here on the entertainment front. Like right now, you'll see the likes of Celine Dion and Tony Braxton. It's a lot going out here. You know what I mean? As far as rock and roll is concerned, it's great. I mean, Elvis Presley was able to do things that haven't been able to be duplicated to this day.
Black American music influenced Elvis. The fact that people say, well, he's the king of it all, king of rock and roll, was a slap in the face to those that made the music possible in the first place. Not to say he wasn't brilliant. I think he was a fantastic, talented singer.
I don't think he ripped them off. I think once something has been exposed, anyone can add or take from it. He was just so great, so popular, so hot, so anything that he played, it became a hit. To me, they didn't make a mistake when they called him the king.
The only thing I want to know, was he my friend? Did I enjoy him as a performer? Did he give the world of entertainment something? Yes, on all counts. And that's the name of that tune.
He was a bundle of energy set to music. And that echo will never die.
Wow. Oh, my goodness. Wow. Oh my God.
That right there was.
Guys,
wow.
Oh my
God. That was like
goodness.
A little movie just now. Like,
yeah.
I forgot we was recording. Like,
wow.
I mean, you know, put an end to all the allegations.
A bundle,
you know,
of energy sent to the music industry, and the echo will never die.
Wow.
Like, to be that much of a force.
And he was loved, man. All
that is
the
so
table.
Powerful.
Yeah.
Wow.
I really enjoyed that.
Oh my goodness. Thank
that
you guys
nice.
So much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
And that clears up a lot.
Requesting us to react to Elvis in the Black community. Oh my goodness.
Elvis in the Black community.
So for anybody that's saying anything other than Elvis was love, if you are spreading lies, rumors, and hate, you know,
I mean,
please stop. Let's just celebrate the legend. Let's celebrate the legend.
I just watched that, and I know that he was an all-around, you know, loving person.
Oh, my goodness. You can't make up things like that,
you
know, about a person. Like, these people, the people, the Black community who knew Elvis personally, oh, my goodness. They absolutely loved him. Imagine if you can make a song and nobody likes it, and then somebody can take that song and blow it up, and then everybody, and not only did he blow the songs up, but, you know, he gave credit for it.
He
like
made them songs popular.
He loved the community. Like, he loved the Black community. He was a huge part of the Black community.
Yeah.
Like, let's not, you know, not acknowledge his works and his love for the Black community. It's not like he took the songs and hated the Black community. No, he absolutely adored the Black community. That is the biggest compliment anybody can ever give to the Black community. Like, come on, guys. Like, really? Really?
Definitely. Like, you know, I mean, the proof is right there. You know, nothing but good comments. And, you know, he had a lot of collabs and, you know, with Black artists. He didn't have the inspirations, so, you know.
And what's the guy who sings Tutti Frutti? Little Richard.
Little Richard.
He said he was upset about him taking Tutti Frutti. He said, "But he made me popular. Made like, you know,
he made the song bigger. He
because we back in those days as African American people or black people or whatever they call them, whatever they call African American people back in the days, Negro people, whatever it was, they didn't, you know, everybody knows the history.
Oh yeah.
Of the culture. And we didn't our people, African American people, you guys know what I'm trying to say. I don't like to get into, you know, race on this channel, but
I mean,
we didn't have the same options and the doors weren't open. I'm going to say that the same doors were not open for black artists back then. And nobody would have really knew who these artists was, who the artists were.
Expanded and made it popular.
Yes. But now he made it, you know, possible for everybody to love these songs and hear these songs. As far as Elvis
stealing songs, I don't really get into all that because I didn't see a whole bunch of artists
remake songs.
You know, remakes of other people's songs. You know what I'm saying?
And I've even seen black artists remake songs that white artists
have. I mean, they just did it. 3 6 Mafia done. Just did it. They just remixed,
you know,
Elvis.
Like, so I'm not going to say, well, he stole that from, you know, like, it's music. Music is for everybody. Music does not have a color.
Right.
Your voice does not have a color. I don't like to get into all of that. You know, guys, we don't really talk about race and color on our channel.
I don't,
you
really
know, we don't do that.
Because,
we don't do that.
That's just a label. Don't really want to get into all
Elvis that. Presley, he was just love, you know? He was like, love.
I think he gave everybody an equal opportunity to, you know, to work with him.
Imagine you have millions of dollars on the line, right? And someone says, well, I'm not going to pay you this million. I'm not going to give you these millions of dollars because you have a Negro woman in your band and we don't bring these ladies because your contract is on the line. And for him to take a step and say, forget your money. Yeah. If they can't come, I can't come. I don't know black people who would do that for each other. I'm sorry. I have to say that.
He definitely took a stand for them ladies. And, you know, that's just the right thing to do. And he probably made a difference right then and there, you know. And then, you know, things started to change down the road.
Yes.
But, you know what I mean? You got to give him the love and respect, man. He was all around the guy.
Yes.
You know? So, and I definitely enjoyed that.
Me too.
Elvis Presley in the black community.
In the ghetto.
Showing nothing but love. Nothing but love. You know, so the proof is there, you know. So if you guys enjoyed this video.
He lived a life. He wasn't singing about something that he knew nothing about.
I mean.
That's what would make me upset. Like, if Elvis was singing about the ghetto and stuff and he came from riches, I would feel some type of way. But this man, Elvis Presley, he was singing about his life.
Guy had soul.
His life. He came from the ghetto. He lived in a shack. He ate banana and peanut butter sandwiches. He didn't have caviar on a spoon.
You know, they struggled. So,
he didn't.
He
knew
about the ghetto.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
He was singing about his life, what he went through, what he knows about the ghetto.
And he put it
out there. Not somebody else's life. So.
And he worked hard to get the things that he wanted to do.
You know, I'm from the ghetto.
Work hard.
Guys.
We are from the ghetto.
And we thank God that we didn't have to raise our children in the ghetto. We got out of the ghetto.
Yes.
And, you know, we try to give our children a better life than what we had.
Oh, yeah.
So I understand, like, I mean, Elvis, I have a huge, we have a connection.
Definitely.
Like, we understand.
A huge connection.
Yes.
And, you know, speak through the music. I understand the music, you know.
Man,
understand the struggle and the pain and the fight.
I'm from all of that. I'm from the,
you know,
the struggle,
so,
the pain.
He made it real clear, you know. And it just seemed like he ain't had no picks and choosies. you know, he was just like a, you know, a real stand-up guy.
Yeah.
Know, so, and proof is there. So, wow. About to sign off, you guys.
If but you did,
guys
you, did you see the guy video, huh? from the radio station breaking the records? Like, no more rock and roll here. This is inner music. Oh, my gosh.
Why? For what reason?
Elvis went through so much.
But he made it.
He went through so much.
And he worked hard. He worked extremely hard.
He opened
hard.
Up so many doors for African-American he artists. Worked hard. Yes, he did. Like, he did it. So, with that being said, please hit the subscribe button. Please turn on your notification bell. Please leave us a comment of what you think. Of Let's course. Watch it Of All course, right. I want to watch it again.
We're going to watch it again, y'all. We definitely got to watch it for the second time.
Yes.
we about to sign up. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. Join the team. S&M Squad, y'all.
For life.
Turn on your post notification bell. And definitely join the team. It's your boy, Shawn.
And your girl, Mel.
It's your favorite couple, y'all. We definitely enjoy that.
Your favorite.
May God continue to bless
everyone. We are my favorite couple. Everyone. Isn't that weird?
Yeah. We
How are we my favorite couple? What's wrong with me? Like, am I weird? I like sitting on here with Shawn. Like,
we love it, y'all.
It's so much fun to work with Shawn. Okay, guys.